Hi, I'm Eric, and I'm making a game called The Black Pepper Crew. I'll be sharing with you my process through development of this game. I think it's fitting for this first Devlog to talk about the evolution of the game to its current state. So, first, a little bit about the game. The Black Pepper Crew is a game about a group of bounty hunters on their journey to collect money, basically. And in each mission, they will engage in a series of tactical encounters that takes them closer to the bounty they intend to collect. There are four characters with different abilities that complement each other. There will not be character progression in the form of a leveling nor equipment system. Instead, I intend to make a meta game around planning for each mission with supplies and with the routes they take to accomplish each mission. I decided to remove the idea of a leveling system and equipment system because I like the simplicity of the encounters, and this adds weight to the planning part of the game. Each encounter is played on an 8x8 board, so each battle ends really fast, hence the idea to have several encounters in a row before taking down the bounty, who will be a boss at the end of each mission. This game started last year on a game jam, where the theme was to create a game inspired in a TV show or episode. I inspired myself from a Simpsons episode called Homer the Vigilante, in which Homer tries and fails to capture a cat burglar that terrorizes the city. I made a stealth game featuring a burglar raccoon that can steal almost everything, and that each item that he steals adds to the final score, but increases the noise from each step he makes, thus complicating mobility. The enemies, if you can call them enemies actually, are sleepwalking bears that can hear the thief if he is within range and makes a noise. If they detect the burglar, they will call the police, transforming the game into a runaway chase. The game was fun, and I decided to expand upon it, but the mechanics wore up after a while of playing, so I took the character design and tried something else. This time I tried with a stealth tactics approach. I changed the burglary theme to a heist theme and added three more characters. I liked the concept, but my intention to create a heist game was too ambitious, and I couldn't figure out how to make the game design work. I know there are successful stealth tactics games out there, but the mechanics are not what I intended for the heist game that I wanted. So I switched from a tactical isometric game into a platforming scroll-based experience. This prototype ended up being fun but difficult to work with. Each character's specific mechanics started to shine. The raccoon will be a lock-picking fella, the cat will be the ninja that could climb walls, the toad will be the muscle of the team, and the chicken will be the hacker. After experimenting once again, I wasn't able to make a single level. It will require some serious game design skills to make that kind of game work. Skills that I didn't have, so I left the prototype behind. I participated in another game jam recently and decided to revisit these four characters, change the game to a bounty hunting theme, and improve the character design. Thanks to the time constraint of the game jam, the development process survived the prototype stage. The result was very fun to play with, and the combination of abilities allowed for different strategies to solve the obstacles through the levels. In the next devlogs, I'll be talking about some of the features that I already implemented. Once I catch up with the current development state of the game, I'll talk more about each week's progress. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next devlog. Bye!